If you are planning to prepare for GATE and are confused how to start, then we will help you with all the information you need to start your preparation. Before that, if you haven't already subscribed to our channel, then go ahead and subscribe and also press the bell icon so that you do not miss out on any of our new videos. Let's get started. First of all, we just want to say that there is no predefined strategy that works for everyone, as each individual is different. The preparation method and strategy should be something which suits you. We just hope to provide you a direction which you can refer to build your own strategy. So now let us discuss how we should approach the GATE preparation. It is very normal for GATE aspirants to look at the vast syllabus of GATE and become overwhelmed and not knowing how to get started. There is no need for you to get worried because we have all been there and have gone through the same situation. Qualifying GATE is not a very easy thing to do, but with proper preparation and plan, you can significantly improve your chances of qualifying. So let us break down what we have to do to ensure that we qualify GATE exam. First, it is very important that you define your goals. It is important to know what colleges you are targeting and also have an idea of the marks you would require to get into those colleges. For example, one would require marks in the range of 55 or 60 out of 100 for getting into IIT Kharagpur, around 45 marks to get a seat in ICT Mumbai, and around 35 marks for getting into NIFTM. Before you start your preparation, you should have an idea of the exam pattern, which includes the types of questions like MCQ, MSQ, NET, the number of questions, marks carried by each question, etc. You can watch our earlier videos on this to learn more about it. So now we need to know what we have to study. For this, we need to analyze the syllabus. We have made a PDF of the compiled syllabus, the link to which you can find in the description. Now we know what all to study for the exam after analyzing the syllabus. The next step is to understand how deep we should study each topic, what type of questions comes from each topic, the common topics that gets repeated frequently, and at last how we should prepare for this. Now this can be done by analyzing the previous year question papers. The GATE exam is very different from our regular semester exams. GATE is more of a problem solving and conceptual analysis. So one cannot have the same approach for a semester exam in college for the GATE exam. Now analyzing the question paper is a must so that we understand the level of the questions asked and the general pattern of the questions. Also, while analyzing the question paper, you should try to relate it with the syllabus. Questions need not necessarily repeat, but topics do, and you can find a few topics which are repeated quite often over the years. You can expect a video from Foodemy in the near future where we will discuss this in detail. Note making is a very important step when it comes to preparation for any exam, especially for students preparing without coaching. Let me tell you why this is important. Now, consider a case where the chapter of proteins in the book Food Facts and Principles by Shakuntala Mani, it has 17 pages. When we will be revising proteins topic at a later time, it will not be efficient to read the entire 17 pages again. This is where note making plays a crucial role. Self-made notes are always easier for revision as well as for easy understanding. Now let us see how the notes should be made for GATE preparation. Notes we make should be in simple and concise form so that we are able to understand the concepts easily when we go through these notes after a few weeks after you have made them. Once the concepts are built, then you can go into the questions that can be asked for GATE. For example, when you are studying fish, you read the line trimethylamine gives the characteristic smell to the fish. Now with your previous year question paper analysis, you understand that this is something that can be asked for the GATE and you note this down. If you follow this strategy, then at the end you will have a self-made note which will have enough matter to give you a high chance of qualifying. Majority of the numerical questions in the GATE exam are asked from the food engineering section. Now these questions are only an extension of the concepts of food engineering. So it is a must that you build a good foundation of the concepts before attempting the questions. Once you build a good foundation of the concepts and a good understanding of the different formulas, then you can start with the solved questions found in books. This will give you an understanding of how to approach the numerical problems. Afterwards, you can attempt the practice questions given in the books. Now, after this, you can attempt the previous year GATE questions from the particular topics. You should also maintain a separate notebook for all the formulas. You can refer to these often for practice by writing them down and keeping yourself sharp with the formulas. There are many books of objective type questions which many students use in the wrong manner. If you study MCQs, then you will just be learning random facts without understanding the concept of the subject. How one should use objective book is by using them after you have made your notes so that you get some extra information and do not leave out any good points. Now, for example, consider the objective question, which microorganism is responsible for the disease botulism? You can learn from a book that the answer is Clostridium botulinum. You learn this particular fact, but the concepts are not clear about botulism. What is botulism, its symptoms, what temperature is required to kill Clostridium botulinum, what process use it as a target microorganism. So you can follow the system we suggested earlier. Consider this scenario. You learn in October or November the 7 steps of HACCP and you are asked in the GATE exam to give the correct sequence of the HACCP steps. Now it would be very difficult for an average student to recall a concept learned a few months back during the GATE exam in February. So for this, we must ensure that we have a regular revision plan. So you should dedicate ample time for revising all the topics we have learned. This will help you to recollect information you learned earlier and apply them during the exam. Once you build a good foundation of your concepts and have a good understanding of the topic, then it all comes to practice. Time management while appearing for the exam is crucial. Now, you cannot dwell on a 2-mark question for 15 minutes because you think you can get it right. You may have to let it go and move to the other questions and come back to the question at the end. Now, mock tests are really helpful to get some practice and get you in the mindset of appearing for the actual GATE exam. Also, mock tests will help you to reflect on what your weaknesses are and where you need to work on to improve your preparation. Sometimes GATE aspirants are not sure about how long they should study per day to have a good chance of qualifying GATE. The time to study every day will depend on the marks you are targeting and the level of knowledge you already have in the subjects and also on your general ability. But generally, 4 to 5 hours of consistent preparation for 4 months should give you a decent chance of qualifying GATE. Now that we have the system in place for our preparation, we now need the tools for it, that is, the books and resources required for your preparation. We shall cover this in our next video. As mentioned in the beginning, this is a system for your reference and you can customize the system according to your situations and style. This is just a reference system to give you an idea of how you can start. Now, we cannot guarantee that you will qualify GATE if you follow this, but your chances of qualifying GATE would improve significantly. Thank you for watching. As always, like, share and subscribe and also leave your feedbacks or questions in the comments. Also, do not forget to follow us on our social media handles.